Namaskaram. In our last class, we have seen some of the list functions, and in today's class, we will continue with our questions. What will be the output of the following Python code? List 1 equal to 10, 40, minus 50, 20. Print max of list 1. The function max will return the maximum value in a list. What is the maximum value here? 40. Next one, what will be the output of the following Python code? List 1 equal to Arun, Amal, Anil. Print min of list 1. Arun, Amal, Anil, error. Which is the answer? Answer is Amal. Those who couldn't answer, please listen. N equal to A, B, D, H. Min of N. That is A. See, I have given min of N, not N dot min. Similarly, max of N is H. So this will find the minimum and maximum values by using ASCII values, or we can say the character which is alphabetically less will be the minimum value, and the character which is alphabetically higher in order, it will be the maximum value. Alphabetically, A is less than B. That is in dictionary order. Another example, S equal to AB, AC, AD. Min of S. It is AB. Here, the first character is same in all these cases. If it is so, then it will check for the second character. Here, the second character B, C and D. B is the minimum value, so it will choose the string AB as the minimum value. If first two values are C, then it will check for the third character. So here in this question, for all these names, first character is C, A, A, A. Then it will go for the second character R, M and N. Alphabetically, M is the minimum value, so it will return Amal as the answer. Clear? Remember, it will not return any error. Next question. The list LST 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 stores the marks of a student. Choose statement to display the total mark. Print sum of LST, total LST, tot LST, sums LST. Which is the function used to find the sum of the values or the total values in a list? Answer is option A, sum of LST. There is no function called total, tot or sums related to list. We will see an example. L equal to 1, 2, 3. Print sum of L. It is 6. Here also it is given as sum of L, not L dot sum. Don't worry, we will discuss about that later. The list LST, the same list, stores the marks of a student. Choose statement to display the average of marks. Option A, print AVG of LST, print sum of LST by LN of LST, average LST, total of LST by 5. Answer is option B, sum of LST by LN of LST. There is no direct function to find the average of values and list. So we can calculate the average by finding the sum of the values divided by length of the list. that is total number of elements. Next one, what will be the output of the following Python code? L equal to 1 4 3 2 5 6, print L dot sort. What is the use of sort function? Yes, it is used to sort or arrange the values in ascending or descending order. The answer is none. Why it is so? I will show you. L equal to 2 5 1 6 7. See this list. L dot sort. What is returned? None. The sort function will not return any value, or we can say it returns none. Then what is there in L? See, it is sorted. The sort function will sort the values in place. It neither creates a new list nor it returns a value. That is why when you give print L dot sort, it returned none. The function L dot sort will return none only. So when you give this function inside the print statement, it will display none. That is why the answer is like this, none. Here print L dot sort is given, so it will return none. And if the question is like this, L dot sort as a separate statement, then print L, the result will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is, the sort function will sort the list in ascending order by default. Then in the next line, it is print L. The list is sorted in place itself. So it will display 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Clear? Next one, fill in the blanks to display the list in descending order. Blank is given here in sort. Options are DSC equal to true, descending, reverse equal to true, reverse. Yes, the answer is reverse equal to true. My list P equal to 4 3 7 8 1 2 P dot sort, reverse equal to true, then print P. The order of P is changed. Now it is in descending order. Don't get confused with the DSC statement in MySQL. Here it is reverse. Reverse equal to true you have to give. Next one, what will be the output of the following Python code? L equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. L dot reverse. Then print L. What is the use of reverse function? Yes, it will reverse the list in place itself. See, the answer is option A, the list in reverse order. Example, L equal to 3 6 2 7 8, L dot reverse, print L. What is the value of L? 87263. This list is reversed. See, there is no order like ascending or descending. It just reversed the order. And also the original list is changed. That is why when I give print L, the reverse list is displayed. So the function reverse will change the list in place. And what is the return value of reverse? None, nothing. These functions you can use the list with strings also. See, P equal to A, B, K, C. P dot reverse. The list is changed. P dot sort. What is the value of P now? It is alphabetically sorted. A equal to 2A5AD. A dot reverse. A is reversed. What about A dot sort? It will show error. Not supported between instances of int and strings. Okay. Then what will be the output of this code? L dot reverse. The return value is stored in R. Then print R. What will be printed? It will print none. Because the reverse function will return none only. Okay. In some of the functions you have used a list name dot the function name, L dot append, L dot extend, L dot insert, L dot remove, L dot pop, etc. And in some functions you have used like this, len of L, min of L, sum of L, like this. All these are functions, but some functions we will use as object name dot function name. Usually those functions are called methods. And why it is so, we will not discuss now. It is beyond your syllabus. So, now you can categorize the functions in your syllabus like this. Functions len, list, min, max and sum are used like this. That is not by using object name dot. And some other functions we will use like this. Object name dot function name. Okay. And we can categorize the functions or methods like this also. Some functions will return a value and some of the functions will not return any value. So these are the functions which return a value. Len will return the length of a list. List function will return a list. Min will return the minimum value in the given list. Max will return the maximum value in the given list. Sum will return the sum of the values in the list. Index will return the index of the given element. Then pop will return the deleted element. And these are the functions which will not return any value. Append function will add an element at the end of the list. It will change the list in place itself. Then extend will add a list at the end of the given list. Then insert will insert an element at the specified index. Then function reverse will reverse the original list, and the function sort will sort the list in ascending or descending order in place itself, and the function remove will remove an element. Okay, this is all about list functions or methods. Thank you.